Important in the lives of these students. They are to be recognized for their accomplishments and their efforts, which allow them to be a member of a prestigious organization. Ladies and gentlemen, we are assembled here this morning for our prestigious affair, the induction of qualifying students into the Los Angeles High School chapter of the National Honor Society. By virtue of the authority extended to Los Angeles High School and its chapter from the National Honor Society, the faculty is admitting the members in the society this morning, those students of the senior and junior class who have most nearly displayed in their school life the worthy objectives of the National Honor Society. No other honor in Los Angeles High School excels that of the membership of the National Honor Society. It represents the fundamental objectives of which high schools are started and given recognition for those who have most nearly achieved and these desired goals. Other honors of this high school are partial in that they recognize only special abilities, skills, or talents. But the National Honor Society looks upon education as a combination of four things of life: character, leadership, scholarship, and service. At this time, I would like to introduce the present members, Nikki Smith. She's the one and only.
We present these candidates for admission to the National Honor Society. I would like to present the students before you as qualified to uphold the principles of the society: Cora Frosta, Grace Gardner, Michaela Hall, Alexis Hogan, Justin Hope, Madison Huffman, Chanel LaBarge, and Derek Turner-Marlow. The principles of the National Honor Society will now be explained to you. The candidates who have pledged to its membership, the candle burning here before you represents the flaming torch, the emblem of our purpose. The unlit candles are symbolic of the four requirements upon which membership is based: character, scholarship, leadership, and service.
Since Nikki's the only member you're going to need to listen to, the two of us speak a lot today, so next year it'll be much different. I'm so excited. First, we're going to speak about character. Each added glow of growth is character, small as it may be, adds to the enlightenment of the world around. Character is the evaluation of one's personality, guided by the influence that controls one's life. Character is measured by not alone by work and deed, but quite as much by what man is when alone with their thoughts. As he grows in his character, his personality becomes increasingly attractive and beneficial to those around him. May you so live your life that you may be an inspiration in your memory of your conviction.
Scholarship. This candle symbolizes the light of knowledge and understanding of the truth of the ages. As it glows, widens the circle of lights. So is the horizon of one's world enlarged with each additional bit of information. Scholarship knows of the past, learns from the present, and plans for the future. It interprets vast treasures for the improvement of the human race. Excellence in scholarship reveals not only that one's store of knowledge has been increased, but also that the individual has endeavored to make the most of the opportunities at hand. Knowledge is both necessary and useful. It can be acquired in only one way, and that is through diligence and effort. May this longing for useful knowledge become part of your life, for the pursuit of knowledge is never ending.
Leadership. To the light of character and scholarship, I would add to the gradients of leadership. This world has always been in the need of people of vision and understanding who can lead the masses in ways of progress and peace. That need presents itself as a greater challenge today more than ever before. Not every person is gifted with the power to lead. To those who possess that gift comes a tremendous responsibility. To him who uses his power well, the world gives honor and glory. To him who betrays this trust comes dishonor and shame. A true leader is marked by self-confidence and poise, both of which are born of experience, knowledge, and understanding of men. Self-confidence is not conceit, but a genuine belief in the righteousness of one's cause and a just appraisal of one's ability and knowledge. We look at you, who have shown some measures of leadership thus far in high school careers, to accept the challenge and become leaders of courage and faith.
Service. As lighting of this candle completes the circle of light, so does the willingness to serve complete the personality of an individual who has a well-rounded life. This candle signifies the brightness and joy of service, the unselfish devotion which gives itself to the need of the individual, of the school, and of the nation. To attain the fullest life, one cannot live for himself and gives it willingly. Service often does not flaunt itself in glowing colors. Its true beauty lies in the simple giving of oneself, one's time, and ability wherever there is a need. The world is full of self-will, self-justification, and self-love, which are all foundations of the world's ills. Today, the world needs individuals who can rise above the tides of the times and serve men unselfishly. May you practice this giving of yourself to others. The candidates that have been instructed at the four stations of character, scholarship, leadership, and service. The ideals of this society have been explained to you. If you desire to assume the responsibility of upholding these standards, you will be given the privilege of taking the membership pledge.
Candidates, will you please rise and raise your right hand and repeat after me this pledge, keeping in mind the great importance. I pledge myself to uphold the high purposes of the society to which I have been elected, striving in every way, by word and deed, to make its ideals the ideals of our school.
You have just made the pledge and you are now ready to be entrusted with the torch, the symbol of our society. I come to place with you two priceless gifts. My first gift has little value in itself. It is but a torch, but without it, you can have no light. Receive the gift, symbol of knowledge unused. Your unlighted torches typify such knowledge. They possess every possibility of service, yet serve not at all. They lack the flame, for the central flame which symbolizes the spirit of National Honor Society. I light this torch of the Los Angeles High School chapter. From this torch, I give you the supreme gift. Just as with this flame, I touch your torch and make it a living thing. So may you, the flame of this spirit, kindle the knowledge which is ours and make it a living thing. As I give light to you, so you give light to others. You may now light your